Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. You're watching Be a Learner. This is Rakesh Suryavanshi. In this channel, we are going to discuss today in this video, we are going to discuss about the LogicApps with integration. In today's topic, we are going to discuss how do you run multiple LogicApps in your Visual Studio code, or how do you run one LogicApp instance and one Azure function instance in your workstation simultaneously or at the same time. In my previous videos, I've shown you that how do we create the workflows with the standard LogicApps within the Visual Studio code. We have created multiple demonstrations with the different type of workflow. One of the workflow is there in my screen right now, as you can see. Now, what do I want to do is, when I run these workflows, let's say if I just simply run right here from this particular section by pressing F5, and if I run this workflow, which is the simplest workflow, of course, if my Azure storage emulator is not going to run, this is what the error I'm going to get. So what this means that I need to, first of all, run the emulator, which is a local emulator, Azure, right? So I'll use a specific common folder and I'll run the Azure. So I'll type in the command Azure, and that will initiate Azure on this folder, and I'll cancel this error for now. So Azure is running with blob, queue, and table. I'll keep this running on the other window. So with the local terminal running, if I run the LogicApp instance right now, you will see that the instance will run on the Azure function host runtime, and that will use a default Azure function host runtime port, which is 7071. And whenever you start running the instances, this is the port number any of your LogicApp runtime will use. So it means that if one Azure function or two or more LogicApp instances in the same Visual Studio code, all of them will try to use the same port number, and that is when the conflict arrives and you won't be able to run it. I'll show you in the demonstration. So as you can see that my workflow is started on the same port which I mentioned, which is 7071. This is working fine, no issues as such. I can test this particular workflow by clicking here on the overview section. I can get this callback URL. I can go to the postman. I can run this by clicking here on the postman. And this is the exactly, let me check that if the URL is correct. I'll copy this over. I think this key which has been generated was changed, and that was the reason I was getting the authorization fail. But now this time I'm getting a success. So every time when you start your local emulator and run the LogicApp functionality, this token has been generated according to the particular instance you are running. So by the way, that's why it was changed and it was not working. But anyways, now it's working. As you can see, I'm getting the response. Now, the point is, if I have multiple instances, let's say this is another instance, which is again HTTP ticket type, but in this time, I'm trying to use something else. I have in the designer, this is a liquid map demo, which is a recurrence type of workflow. I'm trying to call one of the GitHub URI, generate the response, running a liquid map and returning the response back. Now, if I try to run this while the other one is running on the different instance of the Visual Studio code, one here, right? Both of them. Now, let's run this. What happens? As I mentioned, this will also try to run on the same Azure function host, which is 7071. And this time it will try to, this time it will fail. So you can see that the port 7, this is what the error we have got. Let me see. Immediately it has failed, and we got the error that it cannot run because of that issue. Let me rerun again if I can pause this. Yeah, as it says that it's not installed or this not available. Now, two different LogicApp cannot use the same hostname. So how do we resolve this problem? To resolve the problem, what you can do is you can go to this host dot or the task.json file in your Visual Studio project. And if you look at this task.json under the task section, which is an array, first task is we are loading the symbol, and the second task is we are asking to start the function host command, which is host start. And with that host start, what you can say is you can say dash dash port, and then you can specify the port number. Let's say I can specify 7074, for example. So now if I run this LogicApp while the other one is running in the background, this time will start running on 7074 and the other one is on the default port. As you can see that this is starting on the port number 7074 instead of 7071 without having any conflict. And it started on the 70474, debug symbol is also loaded. I'm ready to go and trigger the workflow. If I simply click here, I'm getting the error on my other workflow, which is HTTP caller workflow, which I'll ignore it for now. So if I go back here to the workflow, which is the workflow of the liquid map, which is a recurrence type, which is this one. If I will load this, which is just now, it has run. I'll refresh, resubmit again, which means that I would like to rerun again. And this time I will have two symbols, which proves that kind of this is working fine on the 7074 port. I'm getting a response here as well. Now let's test the other workflow, which is running on the background, which is this one, right? Now, if I go to the Postman, hit the same URL, which is this one. Let's see if it is responding or not. It is responding. So with this task, so we have proven that with this task.configuration, where you can specify the specific port on which you would like to run your LogicApp project. And this way you can run multiple LogicApp instances at the same time within the same machine, and you would be able to test your local host one after other. Let's say if I have a LogicApp workflow running, another one is trying to call the next workflow, then I can simply call that particular project right here from this particular section by specifying the port number. That's it in this demonstration. I hope you have found this useful. If it is, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Thanks for watching it. See you in the next video.